A pleasant day to the young and enthusiastic learners. I am Dr. Shobha Edward, Principal Associate Professor and Head of the Department of Corporate Secretaryship, KCS Kasinadar College of Arts and Science, here to present on the deductions from the income from house property. So when it comes to the deductions, we will solve this question. So there is a person who constructed a house in 30th June 2012. He had two flats of equal size. One is let out for residential purpose at ₹1,000 and the other is let out to a friend for residential purpose at ₹1,000 again, and the expenses pertaining to it are given below. So the municipal value is taken from your question. So municipal rental value is given as 20,000. So it's two equal portions. So we treat it as two houses. So for house one, it is 10,000. House two, it is 10,000. MRV is there. Actual rent is 1,000 per month. So it's 12,000. So MRV or FRV, only MRV is there. So 10,000, that or standard rent, again 10,000. That or actual rent, which is more, 12,000 is more. So 12,000 is taken as the annual rental value less municipal tax. For the whole house, it is 10% of 20,000. So 2,000 for the whole house. So for half this house, that is one portion, it is 1,000. And the conservancy says they have given as 300 for the whole house. So for this portion, it is 150. So the municipal taxes, 1,150 is subtracted and we get the net annual value as 10,850. The other expenses, fire insurance premium, rent collection charges, repairs, interior decoration, legal charges, all these would not be taken into consideration. So now going on to the deductions under section 24, 30% of NAV is the standard deduction. So 30% of 10,850 is 3,255, which is subtracted, and we get the income from the first flat. Similarly, for the second flat, annual value is the same 12,000. Same taxes have been paid. So we subtract, we get the net annual value is 10,850. Standard deduction 30%, 3,255, and we have interest on loan for renovation of the second flat, which is 4,200, which can also be given as a deduction under section 24. So these two deductions put together, it comes to 7,455 to be deducted under section 24. So our income from the second house is 3,395. So house 1 and house 2 together gives us income from house property 10,990. A similar situation where the rental value of the house property is taken from the question, 27,000, and vacancy of 1,000 is subtracted. Vacancy of 1,000 is subtracted and it is taken as 26,000. So from this 26,000, it fetches 500 rent and for 2 months it is vacant. So vacancy of 1,000 is subtracted. So annual value is 26,000 less municipal tax of 9,000, which is paid by the owner. So we get the net annual value 17,000 less deductions under section 24. The standard deduction alone is there. So standard deduction, 30% of net annual value, 30% of 17,000 is 5,100. We subtract and get the income from house property as 11,900. So this property is mortgaged for taking a loan of 50,000 for the purpose of partnership business. So this loan cannot be subtracted. Only if it is taken for repair, renovation or reconstruction of the house, only then we could consider it under section 24. So only standard deduction is given and we get our income from house property. Here there is another question whether rent is given per month. So into 12 we would be taking. Municipal taxes paid is given. Ground rent will not be considered. Insurance will not be considered. Interest on borrowed amount borrowed for construction of the house will be given as a deduction under section 24. Collection charges will not be considered. And the house was mortgaged for meeting the expense of daughter's marriage. That will not be considered. So the interest on loan for this mortgage will not be taken into consideration. So rent is 800 into 12, 9,600. Unrealized rent, that is the rent that they could not realize. So 2,000 rent from the tenant of earlier years could not be realized. So unrealized rent of 2,000 is subtracted. So annual value is 7,600 less the municipal taxes that have been paid 1,800. So 1,800 is subtracted. We get the net annual value, and from that 30% standard deduction, 5,800 into 30% is 1,740, and the interest on loan, that 1,000 rupees for reconstruction or repair of the house alone is allowed as a deduction. So together the deductions come to 2,740, and the income from house property is 3,060. Here there's a situation where municipal rental value, actual rent is given, municipal taxes is given, date of completion, date of letting, fire insurance premium and ground rent will not be considered. Interest on loan would be taken into consideration. So interest on delayed payment of interest will also not be considered. MRV or FRV, which is more MRV, that or standard rent which is less, again the MRV, because only that is there. That or actual rent which is more, 30,000 is more, so annual value is 30,000 less the municipal tax paid, 2,400. So your net annual value is 27,600. Deduction under section 24, standard deduction, so 30% of net annual value, which is 8,280. Now going on to the interest on loan. Interest on loan for the previous year 1920, which is 10,000, is taken as it is. And interest on loan for the pre-construction period, that is from the date of borrowal till the date of completion of the house, interest on loan that is taken is called as pre-construction interest. And this interest can be claimed in 5 installments. So this interest comes to 30,000, which is claimed in 5 installments. So you divide it by 5. So you get the pre-construction interest as 6,000. So total interest to be deducted, 16,000. So under section 24, our deductions are 24,280. On subtracting, our value comes to 3,320 as income from house property. Now moving on to the next question, we have actual rent 19,200, standard rent 18,000, whichever is more, 19,200 less municipal tax which is paid by the owner 1,000, and you get your net annual value 18,200. And from this we subtract the standard deduction, 30% of net annual value, 30% of 18,200, which is 5,460, and on subtracting we get 12,740. And there has been unrealized rent recovered. Unrealized rent recovered is 14,000, of which 16,000 was allowed as a deduction, 12,000 was allowed as a deduction, but the actual amount was 16,000, so 4,000 was not allowed as a deduction. So this 4,000 is subtracted, 14,000 minus 4,000, so 10,000 unrealized rent which is recovered is deemed to be income from house property. Again, the unrealized rent for an earlier year is 16,000, of which they have deducted 12,000. So 12,000 is deducted, 4,000 is not yet deducted. So that 4,000 which is not deducted is deducted from the unrealized rent recovered, and the balance is taken as deemed to be income from house property. So the total income from house property is 22,740. Now going on to this situation, you have a house which is self-occupied, a house which is let out for 500 rupees per month, and the municipal value of the house that is self-occupied is 2,600 and the other house is 5,200. The municipal tax of the two is 600 and the other expenses, insurance premium we will not consider, annual charge we won't consider, ground rent, repairs we will not consider. Only interest on loan 400 we would consider. So now moving on to our solution. So two houses, let out house and a self-occupied house. So for the let out house, municipal value is 5,200. Rent received is 500 into 12, which is 6,000. So annual value is 6,000 minus the municipal taxes. So when it comes to the municipal taxes, for the entire house, the municipal tax is 400. So this is divided in the proportion of their municipal value. So for the self-occupied house, the value is 2,600 and the let-out house, it's 5,200. So 26 is to 52. So in that ratio, you are going to divide this municipal tax. So municipal tax is divided. So 2/3 of 600, which is 400 for the let out house, and for the self-occupied house, I would tell you when I reach that position. So this is subtracted and we get the net annual value. Now the standard deduction is a income tax provision which we have to give 30% of net annual value, 30% of 5,600 which comes to 1,680, and the interest on loan again we had it given as 400 over here. So this 400 is divided in that proportion. So 2/3 of 400 is 267. So the total of deductions under section 24 is 1,947. So net annual value minus deductions will give you the income from the let out house, 3,653. And from the self-occupied house, annual value is always taken as nil, and we will give only one deduction, that is the interest on loan. Interest on loan is 400 into 1/3. So it is 133. Annual value is nil, less deduction under section 24 is minus 133. So there is a loss from the self-occupied house which is minus 133. So the two houses put together, we get our income as 3,520. And our question says that he has income from other sources which is to be considered in our answer. So when we go to the total income, his income from other sources is 20,000. So this income from other sources also added, and his total income works out to be income from house property 3,520, income from other sources 20,000, which totals to 23,520 as his total income. So this is with regard to the deductions in respect of income from house property. The two deductions, one standard deduction 30% of net annual value and interest on loan. And standard deduction is only given for the let out house. For the self-occupied house, there is only one deduction, which is your interest on loan. And this interest on loan should be taken for repair, renovation, reconstruction or construction of the house. Only then it can be given as a deduction. And interest on loan taken for the pre-construction period, that is from the date of borrowal to the date of completion of the house is called as pre-construction interest, and that can be claimed in 5 installments, 5 consecutive years. They can claim it as a deduction as pre-construction interest. So thank you, and have happy and smart learning.